important to notice here. This is not exactly a regular expression, right? Because in regular expression, you are not allowed to write this N. Right. First, you tell me, is this a regular language? Yes. Somebody charming said it is no, sir. So definitely no, it is not a regular language because you can't draw any figure for this. Okay. But in this case, if I give this kind of language to develop or to give a CFG for this, then you have to rely on your intuition, and there is no such written method for this. Okay, so what is the thing that we need to have a grammar which will generate equal number of A's followed by the same number of B's, right? So we can have a start symbol S, and it can be something like this. A is B. Now look at this. If I expand this or derive from this, it will give me A is B. Again, if I do A is B, right? But if I see here, what is saying that N equal to, look at this, N equal to, or sorry, greater than equal to 1. That means N can be 1, 2, 3, and so on. Now, if N equal to 1, then this derivation is not going to be take place, right? So this derivation will not be there. Okay. Instead, we should do what? This S to epsilon. Then only it is going to satisfy. So I will add another rule, S to epsilon. So we have the grammar here for the given language. Okay. Okay. Now consider context-free grammar S equal to SS plus SS, SS multiplication and A. And given string is A plus A multiplication. Okay. Give a rightmost derivation for the string. Give the, sorry, leftmost derivation for the string. Give a rightmost derivation for the string and give parse tree for the string. So give a parse tree. The derivation trees are basically the parse tree. So the third one does not valid at this moment. So first two thing you do. Can you answer? You have to draw a leftmost derivation. You have to generate a leftmost derivation and rightmost derivation for this given string. If you are doing it, please write yes, otherwise I will not understand. It is a 2 minute answer, anybody can do it. Upload it. By the way, leftmost derivation is what? We have to start from the start symbol, then you are doing leftmost derivation, then you start searching for a non-terminal from left to right, correct? So we do this, we get this S passed, right? So we may choose this one. S is just a minute. There is one production missing again, I think, because here we need to generate a star. A star. That means okay, let me try. I don't know. There may be. Let me try with this and let me see whether it is stopping somewhere. And then I will add accordingly because this is the problem from a book. So I should try it. Okay. So doing a left first derivation, say at the end we have star. So I choose this production rule first, S to S asterisk. Okay, so we get this. Then we do again the leftmost derivation. So leftmost symbol is this first S. Okay, this one. So this time I apply this rule S plus. Okay. Then again from leftmost derivation we are doing. So this S we will choose and this will be replaced by S to ID. Okay. Then this left, from this side, this is the leftmost S, so not ID, sorry. This case we have A. Okay, then this S becomes A and this S becomes A. Okay. So if I read it, read the leaves, what do we have? A plus A star. Okay. So there is no mistake in the given grammar. Okay. My prediction, okay, it was wrong. So again, this was our leftmost derivation. If I do rightmost derivation, again we start from S. Okay. And first we will apply this rule, S star. Okay, then this S need to be tried first, so by S to A. Okay, next we have this S which need to be tried, and we will get S plus. And again, we do rightmost derivation. So this S is the rightmost S. So we drag this one. So not ID. A. And then again, from the right to left, we are searching. So we get this S. So again, we have generated A plus A star. Okay, so we have one leftmost derivation here. Do we have a rightmost derivation here? So can anybody tell me whether this grammar is a ambiguous grammar or not? Does anybody think that this grammar is ambiguous? Look at these two derivation. They are same or they are different. These two derivation trees are structure are same, correct? Now, to prove that this grammar is ambiguous, you have to find out some of at least one string for which you are able to generate multiple derivation tree. Okay, so I think that this is not a ambiguous grammar. Okay, this is non-ambiguous. Okay, so this is already have done. Okay, so is this grammar is ambiguous or unambiguous? Justify your answer. Describe the language generated by the grammar. Okay, so can anybody describe the language generated by this grammar? What is the language generated by this graph? Can anybody tell me? See, this kind of question can be there in the exam. Okay, so you must be ready for this. You can see what kind of language it is generating. It is generating only a, it can generate a star or a plus. So it is generating basically first fix notation of arithmetic operations, right? Arithmetic expression. Shen, Eugene, star, two operations, right? And plus. Is that it? See, two operand, then one operator. That means what? It is basically in fix, it is a plus a. In post fix, it is a plus. Yes, Pandey, that is not description of the language, okay? And this is not generating a and so on. It is, there is that addition sign and multiplication sign that you have to consider. Understand? So in this kind of questions, if you just you know, give your answer in hurry without thinking, say you have 3 marks or 2.5 marks for this, and if somebody thinks that, oh, 2.5 marks within by writing one line, then you know, there is a high chance of getting zero. Okay, but when you will look at there that, okay, there is more than 1 marks, okay, in this kind of questions, you should be immediately cautious and take time. Okay, now consider the context free grammar given here. Can you generate the string using by you know derivation? How many steps you have to need? You have to take. It has just answered that. How many derivation steps you will take? Three. Anybody else have any answer? So first step is basically 0 is 1. Next step is 0 is 1, and another step is 0 1. So what I have in this, if you look at this, we have 0 0 0 1 1. So in 3 step we can generate this. Okay. Who is this Manish is joining right now the class? So, X can never appear in the derivation of any sentence. Okay, so what is this? Okay, so what is useless symbol in the grammar? So if you find that there is some symbol in the grammar which is not appearing in a derivation tree, in any case, then you will say this is a useless symbol here. Okay. Now, remove, if there is some useless symbol in the given grammar here, remove them. First, you tell me, is there any useless symbol? Is there any useless symbol in this grammar? Somebody said A. Nitish said A. Anybody else having any answer? So yeah, A is definitely one of the useless symbol here, not by this definition, but in other way, A will, okay, no, in derivation of any sentence. Yes, so there you can understand that A, you can, in derivation tree, A can arrive. S to A you can have. Okay, you can have A to A, B, this step also. But after that, what you will do with this A? This A will never be terminated with a terminal. Okay, so this is a useless symbol from that sense. Okay, but from this B, you can, this one can come anytime and it will be terminated. But this will give you only recursively, A to AB, A to AB, and so on. Now, why regular expressions do define the lexical syntax of a language? So, why use regular expression? Right? Now, first thing is separating the syntax structure of a language, syntactic structure of a language, into lexical and non-lexical part provides convenient way to modularize the font and of compiler into two measurable, manageable, sized component. One is lexical analyzer, another is parser. Lexical analyzer, we use regular language, sorry, regular expressions. In syntax analyzer, we use contextual grammars. Okay, so the lexical rules of language are frequently quite simple, and to describe them, we do not need a notation as powerful as grammar. Okay, so another reason is that the lexical rules are quite simple, right? It is as simple as for Q identifiers or variable name. We know that it will start with alphabets A to Z, or it can be start with capital A to capital Z, but it should not start with digit. Okay, and after this, we can have digits, zero to nine, and like that, or underscore also. Okay, so this is a simple rule. So for implementing or for checking this out, we don't need to use the complex and more costlier expression like grammar. Instead, regular expressions can do it. Okay. So quite simple, and to describe them, we do not need notation as powerful as grammar. Okay, so regular expressions generally provide more concise and easier to understand notation for tokens than grammars. Okay, so it is more concise. Okay, the basic scope is limited, and very concisely defines and understandable that what are the acceptable acceptable string here. It is very simple. Now, more efficient lexical analyzer can construct it automatically from regular expression than forming arbitrary grammar. Understand? So it is more efficient to develop.